and welcome to EduMate.tv. I'm Chetan Sharma. We learn to live and live to learn in what has turned out to be an unprecedented situation, an unprecedented pandemic. With history being written across the geography of Mother Earth, and a minor virus has created a major catastrophe, making each and every one of us rewind, reset, reboot, reformat, restructure, re-strategize before we rebuild. Rebuild a new world, a new normal. In the field of higher education, they say, the only thing constant is change. In a pandemic, they say, the only thing certain is uncertainty. It's important to consider that all progress must come from change. But it's also important to consider that all change does not lead to progress. And that's what makes the situation exceptionally unique, as it throws open several challenges which require unique solutions, and more importantly, unique opportunities. That's why we at EduMate believe in sharing and caring as we get together to learn and earn from each other. The entire ecosphere, the parents, students, teachers, educators, educrats, edupreneurs, vice chancellors, and principals, to bring together a diaspora of knowledge, analysis, news, and views. The one sole intention of ensuring that Generation Next has a far firmer footing than Generation Y as we move ahead. This program is brought to you by EduMate.tv. It's produced by Ahead Education, an organization that believes in taking education ahead. And I say with great pride that it's powered by one of India's better universities from the East, the Adamus University. As always, in all our colloquiums, and this being about 125th of ours, we have a host of special guests and luminaries from a diverse set of fields. Let's take a look first at who our very special speakers are, as I wish each and every one of you on this holy occasion a very happy Navratri.
I'm proud to be part of Adamus University.
Adamus University.
Let's start with our first speaker, Professor Ujjwal Chaudhary. Please talk us through why media remains a great career option.
Yes, there is a contraction in print media. To my knowledge, more than 5,000 people have lost jobs in the regular and the major print media. On the other hand, there have been a large number of online and digital media initiatives that have come up in the last few months itself, including this very platform on which we are talking, EduMate.tv. And I really appreciate and admire the effort taken by you and your team to launch a niche education-focused channel in this context. There has been, if you look at jobs, there's one. But if you look at initiatives of media, it has actually increased. It has increased because they're taking a new shape now. Events are becoming e-events. Branding is going primarily digital. Entertainment is entering into wave entertainment phase in a big way. It's not without reasons that you find more than 10 Bollywood films and at least 12 Hollywood films, to my knowledge, which have been released on OTT platforms, including those in which big stars have acted, including Amitabh Bachchan, It's interesting to see 720% rise in the OTT. It's also interesting to see mobile journalism taking roots in a big way. The channel, the YouTube channel of Barkha Dutt, Mozo, as you know, Mozo YouTube, had registered huge visibility and, you know, audience in this period. So across all forms of media and communication, there has been a rise in visibility, in audiences, in loyalty increasing of the audiences. Yes, the circulation figures have gone down, but that's a skewed mind. 20th century was the medium of print, or rather last 30 years of the 20th century, print dominated media. The first 20 years of 21st century is electronic media dominated media. And as we see now, it's going to web first, and within web also mobile first. So it is increasingly becoming web-led entertainment, web-led journalism, web-led brand communication, even web-led events, events which were supposed to be fully physical. So any education that focuses on web-led communication education, media education, entertainment education, will be the education of the future. If out of the 972 universities of the country, let me very humbly say, almost 900 of them have print-led journalism education. Some of them have started television now. But web-led journalism education, very, very rare. Yes, I would appreciate ACJ, Asian College of Journalism. I will appreciate in Chennai. I'll appreciate IIJNM in Bangalore. I'm happy to say that this year we have also launched web-led journalism, multimedia or convergent journalism masters. And we are calling it convergent journalism very particularly. Only 3 or 4 universities in the country actually recognize journalism as convergent journalism. So it's important to understand there is career, but the career that change of career has happened, not just medium wise, but many other perspectives wise also. The Fikki Frame's latest report, which has come out only a few days ago, says that 2022 is poised for a 33% growth on what it would be in 2020.
Us waqt journalism mein glamour bilkul nahi tha. We joined journalism because we liked it. We thought it's a very good career, aur banking jaise boring career se hum bach jayenge. Thank God I did not choose banking. Us waqt jo bhi journalism mein aata tha unke liye mission hota tha. ऐसा नहीं होता था कि IAS के जितने एस्पिरेंट्स हैं उनको IAS में एडमिशन नहीं मिला तो वो जर्नलिस्ट बन गए, राइट? ये भी हमने देखा. प्रिंट वाज रोलिंग ऑफ कोर्स. देन 90s में टेलीविजन का बूम हुआ, हम सबको पता है. देन वी गॉट अ थ्रेट. हम सब की मीटिंग्स में कहा गया कि नाउ बिकॉज टेलीविजन इज देयर, न्यूज चैनल शुरू हो रहे हैं, तो प्रिंट मीडिया खत्म होने वाला है. आपको अपने आप को इतना अट्रैक्टिव बनाना होगा, आपको अपने आप को लोगों के सामने ऐसे पेश करना होगा कि टीवी भूल के वो वापस प्रिंट में आ जाए. बिलीव मी, वो थ्रेट चला नहीं, तब भी प्रिंट मीडिया ने सर्वाइव कर लिया, ठीक है. और अब हम सब ऑनलाइन की बात करते हैं, करनी भी चाहिए, क्योंकि पेंडेमिक के टाइम पे अगर मैं पिछले 6 महीने से वर्क फ्रॉम होम कर पा रही हूँ, इसीलिए कर पा रही हूँ थैंक्स टू टेक्नोलॉजी. तो इस टेक्नोलॉजी की वजह से हम सब ने अपने आप को तैयार कर लिया है कि हम प्रिंट के साथ साथ ऑनलाइन की बात सोचें. लाइक अभी प्रोफेसर साहब ने जैसे कहा कि प्रिंट मीडिया से बहुत लोगों की नौकरी गई, वेरी ट्रू, हम सबको पता है. आई डोंट हैव टू कोट द इंस्टीट्यूशन से कहां कहां से किन किन की नौकरी गई है, लेकिन इसमें ऑनलाइन में जो भी काम कर रहे हैं उनकी नौकरियां नहीं गई है. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया ने छेद खुद बना लिया अपना, उन्होंने बता दिया कि आप उन पे ट्रस्ट नहीं कर सकते, आप सिर्फ खबर दे सकते हैं, लेकिन खबर की जो चीर फाड़ करते हैं वो प्रिंट ज्यादा अच्छा करता है. आने वाले दिन में मीडिया के लिए अलग अलग तरह से बहुत अच्छी ओपनिंग्स होने वाली हैं, और इसमें इंग्लिश से ज्यादा मेरा मानना है वर्नैकुलर मीडिया, वर्नैकुलर लैंग्वेजेस अपना बहुत बड़ा रोल अदा करेंगे.
मीडिया इज अ यूटिलिटी व्हिच विल नेवर गो अवे. इफ यू कीप अपग्रेडिंग योरसेल्फ and keep pace with progress and are open to adopting new things, then you will see that there are many ways of progressing. And second thing, if you are ready for change, then look at the way, look at the opportunity. You know, print was very prominent at one point of time. Then you had radio, you have TV, now we have online, and online is going into so many different ways, right? You have social media. In social media itself, you know, you can do so many things with Twitter. We didn't even know about Zoom largely before the pandemic. Look at the amount of things which is happening over Zoom, like this webinar also. So first, media is not only about journalism. Media is about enablement of what we call visualization of news, visualization of information between what is happening and becoming that filter which is unbiased in ensuring that information becomes news when news is put in context. And when the context is good, then it becomes more useful to everybody. Media can't survive without commercially being viable, right? So for that, you will either need a subscription revenue or you will need advertising. In terms of the pandemic and its aftermath, I would say that without media, it's going to be difficult for even the economy to revive, because for any economy or any product to be sold, you need publicity and advertising.
I have seen that there is a glaring lack of content focused on media revenues, media management in most media education.
You obviously look at an opportunity to fill a need which is a vacuum in society. That's got to be the core and the premise of entrepreneurship. So what is that need gap which you chose to focus?
When, as a television journalist, we need to, I can talk about television because I was a television journalist. The reason why I left television is when I actually started thinking, are we talking about stories of public interest or are we talking about stories in public interest? And that's the whole point. What kind of stories are we as journalists going to talk, communicate to the people? There is a need for the audience to move from content which is quantity based to quality based. In the media, the job opportunities are gone. Most of my colleagues have lost jobs, and even the best journalists who have broken some of the biggest news stories their salaries have been slashed. So the job scenario in the media industry for experienced and senior journalists is not that great. I see an opportunity for the youngsters here, because most media channels, television channels or the print, they're doing cost cutting now. And they are recruiting more youngsters because they want multi-skilled, multi-talented youngsters, young professionals. Just because media organizations now, because of the pandemic, they want to be leaner organizations. So I really feel that for all the youngsters who are listening to this webinar, it's a great opportunity for you guys to upskill, because there is a lot of time, you're at home, there's nothing much to do. It's a great time for you to be doing internships, for you to be doing courses, upskill yourselves. Also try working in certain organizations, look for opportunities. I really feel that the way we look at media is really changing. The way we look at content is really changing. And I really think that the quantitative approach towards journalism is shifting to qualitative approach. People now are willing to pay for content because there are multiple news channels, there are multiple newspapers or digital platforms. They're all coming up with the same content. I really feel that if students can be good storytellers, I mean, if you can learn to tell stories differently, uniquely, I think there is a huge future for all the youngsters.
The very integral part of media, which is lesser spoken about, that's public relations and managing media.
This is a very lucrative field, a very opportunistic field, and it is constantly evolving. And my personal belief is that every crisis, you know, is an opportunity for us to reiterate, to reinvent, and those who will quickly adapt. And you know, the more vulnerable you are, the more open you are towards new ideas, working closely, and the way forward I see is collaboration. So, you know, while earlier public relations in India would probably be equal to or synonymous with media relations, and that's how we all started our careers, right?
you know, that's how, you know, clients would understand that, you need a press release to be issued and get coverage, or you would need to do a press conference. But today it's so much more. Today, public relations is multi-pronged, it's 360 degrees. Even as an agency, we have quickly, you know, scaled up from just offering public relations services to branded solutions, branded content, digital media, and some of you have spoken about that everything is being transitioned on the virtual world. It's only those smarter ones who will be able to upgrade their skills, quickly move on to the next level. Understand, you always have to be ahead of the curve, right? I mean, this is a game changer for all of us. And I think for students, you know, we work with a lot of interns. In fact, as an agency, we've hired a lot of people during this period of 6 months. We've also taken a lot of interns on board, because I think interns, fresh minds, they're bubbling with ideas, they're very enthusiastic. And one of the messages that I like to give to people is, this is the only field, you know, media, public relations, content, communication, whatever we call it, they're all, you know, different sides of the same coin. You get to work with the decision makers. You can use this time to scale up. Do a lot of research, do a lot of reading, because unfortunately, or fortunately, this new gen millennials, you know, want to, work in a very quick way or short ways of, but there's no shortcuts. It's all hard work, right? So you have to go back to the drawing table all the time. So it's not all bad news. I see this as only a stepping stone to a bigger opportunity, a bigger platform that is growing.
Let's just get across to our students who are at the core of this colloquium and take a look at some of the questions which are thrown up. A lot of them are filtering our way.
What are the different job opportunities post-graduation in media field?
Future of the digital is social. So if you know how to use Twitter, if you know how to use Instagram, Facebook, blogs in a very productive manner, and sometimes to bring in your stories and stories which are genuine, or the journalistic stories, and also sometimes to build the images of your organizations, gaming is going to be the biggest quantum of business. Rise of quantum of business will be highest in the context of gaming. It's already seen in the last 2 years, and it will be coming. And gamified education, quizified education would be another option. It's not just about gaming for entertainment, gaming for education as well. News, kids, and entertainment. These three genres are already standing out. Augmented reality, virtual reality. Please look into your postgraduate course wherever you are getting. Are you being taught about media technologies? No university or college largely at this point of time has a clear idea about virtual studios, virtual production, and things like that. Artificial intelligence in media. Personalized recommendations for media consumption. Creating or suggesting content which will have an audience. This can come through artificial intelligence. Blockchain, pay-per-view or pay-per-use of content. So according to content consumption, you pay. Now this comes through an application of blockchain in the context of media and entertainment. Media management and media revenues. Education that teaches you how to monetize good content. Advertising, which is connected to viewership or clicks, and which is connected to revenue. We have to go beyond and understand media and communication in the new normal, in the post-pandemic era, where digital first and mobile first is the word to go.
Is going for higher education in mass communication necessary? If yes, what course will be most fruitful in media and communication profession?
Every bit of media that we talk about, whether we talk about the contemporary media, which is movie, video games, social media kind of thing, or the traditional media that we talk about, the television, radios, and print media. And now, the new evolving media end, which is technology and management that we are talking about. Everything is needed. We are looking at improving and making a job profile which can make a student a digital marketing specialist. Every organization today, and situations which is life challenging or the disruptive situation that we are in for the last 6 months, you require people to have a proper planner to do their media plan. Because media has diversified areas. Very many things are coming. Public relations, we see an example in Ms. Kulkarni out here, when we are talking of digital media as a forte, don't you think that it requires intricate planning and understanding of the digital media? That is, so social media managers, web content managers, I mean, I can talk about innumerable number of opportunities which can give explore, I mean, you can explore as a student.
Rajan Sharma wants to know, considering the current downslide of media, what is the scope of mass communication as a career in post-COVID world? Can we enter media without doing a professional course?
Journalism, public relations, digital media marketing, social media management, branded content, journalism, you know, these are all career options, and there is a humongous scope in each one of them. And I think for me, it's more about also the aptitude, you know, the aptitude and the passion for what you want to do. I always say PR is my passion, not just a profession, because that's only how you're going to progress. And at every point in time, you've got to upscale yourself. Events is another very big, you know, opportunity. So a lot of online events are happening. So you can just pick and choose as per your area of interest. A lot of universities also offer major minor courses. So you can even take a combination of these. And you can do a parallel courses to kind of, you know, keep upgrading yourself.
Looking at the current state of media, I really feel that it's very important for journalists to know what they're talking about. For instance, a legal reporter should know the law, I mean, to understand what is happening in a court. Or a defense reporter should have some kind of a specialization, or some, at least that the defense reporter must have attended some courses on defense so that he understands the various terminologies. But more than that, I really feel on-field knowledge. While you're doing a mass communications course, it's very important to be very grounded and do those internships. Those internships, instead of asking, where are the job opportunities? Because job opportunities will always be there in one place or the other. Instead of asking, where are the job opportunities? You need to ask, what is your call? What are you good at? And when you're connected to the industry, with various industries, not one industry, don't go behind one particular opportunity. It could be photography, it could be video editing, it could be advertising, it could be, you know, PR, it could be, you know, it could be even teaching journalism.
Which sector in media will boom post-COVID?
Mm-hmm.
And Mansi wants to know, I have studied psychology in graduation. Which field in mass communication should I opt for? Will PR be a good choice?
The boom is going to be largely in digital medium and streaming medium, and there are going to be lots of new things which are being built even as we speak. VideoTap, my company, is one example of that, where we are doing absolutely revolutionary things in terms of how video will be consumed in the future by the entire industry globally. We also need to look for some kind of the technology-enabled media companies, which are platforms which are going to be the future, which will be in their peak in the next 10, 15 years.
It's not about psychology, it's about your choice of communication. There are three types of communication. Communication of information and analysis, that's journalism. Communication of entertainment, that's about cinema, TV and all that, wave entertainment and all that. And communication of persuasion, that's about brand communication. So if you are reporting on Hathras horror, psychology is required, that's journalism. If you are making a short film for Mumbai International Film Festival, then also psychology is required. When you make the script and screenplay and you present it, package it properly. Or if you are building the image of your client, let's say the current Asian Paints ad, which focuses on celebrating Durga Puja at home from a safe distance, it actually goes into the psychology of both the individual and the family in a Bengali context. So psychology is necessary in all the three aspects of communication. I would strongly recommend PR for you if your inclination is about image building, about content developing, about research in communication. Yes, public relations requires to understand from individual to organizational to mass psychology. Psychology of the individual, particularly who are at the helms of affairs. Understanding of the organizational behavior and organizational psychology, and also understanding of mass psychology or people psychology in general. Psychological, psychology as a domain is fundamental to any form of communication because you are dealing with human minds.
Shouldn't we have stronger media law considering how things are with media right now? Is it even necessary to go for higher studies in media? Is going for higher studies need of an hour or taking up a job if offered one in media?
The newspapers, we all know, it is governed by the Press and Registrations of Books Act, and the Press Council is regulating the newspapers. As far as television is concerned, we know that the Cable Television Networks Regulation Act is governing them, and we have this Electronic Media Monitoring Center under the Information and Broadcasting Ministry. Now the government is also trying to bring in a regulation to regulate the digital media, and the government basically wants to replace the Press and Registrations of Books Act, and basically they want the entire digital media also to be registered under the RNI, the Registrar of Newspapers of India. So I really feel that laws will always be there. There will always be regulations. If the digital media is not regulated right now, it will happen in the near future, maybe in the next 1 or 2 years. But it's not about laws really, it's about media ethics. It's about editors or editor-in-chiefs, people, journalists who are in positions of power. What kind of stories are they telling the people? So it comes from within. Most of the questions that the student community want to ask is not really a case of violation of any law as far as media is concerned. It's about ethical questions. Whether should this story have been reported like this?
Gut-feel journalism and gut-feel communication cannot be professional communication or professional journalism. And I'm not talking only of journalism. I'm talking of all forms of media and communication, whether it's advertising, whether it's public relations, event management, entertainment production or entertainment management, or journalism. And journalism across all the four media, print, on air, on cyber, or on radio. Don't you think that you need a technology savvy, good quality, professionally packaged and produced education for you, where you bring in experiential learning by doing classroom teaching that is brick and mortar, and online learning, digital learning that is click and portal, combining experiential brick and portal?
What future new job opportunities are going to open up in mass communication, and is it essential to have a higher study degree for that? I am not a good writer, I realized during my graduation. Should I continue further studies in mass media, or should I choose some other field? What skills should I develop as an aspiring student of media communication, and which is the highest paid option in media in terms of job? Too many courses to choose from, even within the focused sphere of communication. Most colleges, universities, and institutes split up their offerings, confusing you even more.
Sometimes I feel we didn't have so many choices, and you have a clutter of choices now, and it is difficult. But the point, I think educators, institutions, professionals, we're all trying to make that there is a big world out there. You know, pick up your choice, go with it. Of course, it's only going to build up over a period of time, but it's just growing. I mean, one of the points we probably didn't touch upon was data analytics. 10 years back or 15 years back, data analytics wasn't so big in communication. But today, whatever we do, whether it is PR, advertising, everybody wants to know what's the impact. Social media, right? I mean, that's how the ROIs are being measured. We're still evolving, a variety of techniques for measuring those communication effectiveness. There's a lot of content writing courses available. Today, there are content writing startups, who are doing extremely well. You just post your requirement. I mean, we, a lot of PR agencies do take use of that.
You should not give up a mass communications course just because you think you're not a good writer. Because as far as journalism is concerned, I can tell you, you need not be a good writer, because there are always in newspaper organizations, there are always editors, writers who will write your story. In television, it's unfortunate, but 15 years I have not written my stories. I've just gone out on the field and I've reported my stories and I've sent my stories, and somebody sitting in Bombay would write the script. In my organization, I'm not looking at good content writers. I'm looking at reporters who can just go out there, communicate with the people, find out a story, and come back and tell the story. I mean, so if you are a good writer, it's great. But then if you're not a good writer, it doesn't really matter. A reporter need not be a good writer. A field reporter need not be a good anchor. A reporter need not be a good speaker. Or what a reporter needs to know, or what a journalist needs to have, is just empathy. Just go out in the field, understand what the story is, get to the bottom of the story, you know, and come back to the office and write about it in the way you can. And if your writing is not good, there will always be a set of editors or your mentors in the company who would be able to help you publish that, get that story published.
Many of us who feel dilemma, I had the privilege of having a professor of ethics in Harvard who gave this example. He said, if you have a moral dilemma always, you extend the timeline. Instead of looking at it, should I, let's say, do this once or not? If you have that kind of a question, usually he says, can I do this for 15 years? Can I do this for 20 years? And automatically, you know, any ethical dilemma you have will go away. In the same way, when you're trying to pick whichever aspect or vertical within the media profession, just ask yourself, as you're starting very early, you know, you're starting off in your careers, will I be comfortable doing this for the next 5 years or 10 years? That's a very easy question to ask yourself. If you think you feel passionate, you're comfortable doing that, then try it out. And more importantly, if it doesn't work, don't feel bad about that. You can just switch to another aspect of the same thing. Don't chicken out at the earliest sign of trouble, because every profession is not glamorous. It is hard work. It is like, you know, you need to put in the effort. You know, your PR looks very glam. It is not. It's lots of hard work, late hours, 100% accuracy.
A job is a derivative of what education you have. If you know, if your knowledge is there, jobs are there to take. So there is no dearth of jobs. Because learning cannot be correlated with jobs. Let me tell you that. Learning is educating yourself, and like what Dilip was also mentioning, even Sonia mentioned. So there is a lot of hard work that one needs to give. You need to get your base right. And not to forget, follow your passion. Dil se karo. Jo dil se hoga, wo sahi hoga.
Future areas in media: mobile first, web first journalism, web first entertainment or web based entertainment, and web based brand communication. Having been the top web at the beginning, it would be convergence, it would continue to be convergence. So television would not disappear at all, it will be quite strong, maybe it becomes more niche. And print will also remain, because there are new educated pockets of India, and people would take time to change behavior. So that's about web-based communication will be the future. Second, not writer, no problem. There is the technology side of media and communication. In our university, we have BSc, MSc Media Technology. So there is SEO, SMM, Search Engine Optimization, Social Media Marketing, use of social media as a whole. There is a strategy side of media. There is management side of media. As we have told earlier, monetization of the communication or monetization of content. These do not require writing skills. These require more strategic mind going ahead. Skills ahead. Audience measurement. People do not understand audiences. Just now television scam has come out. TRP scam has come out. You understand now how poor is the Indian technology and tools with respect to audience measurement, whether it's print, cyber, audio or video at all levels. So audience measurement skills, broadcast technology skills, as has been said by everyone, storytelling, video storytelling would be the most important platform of media ahead. And digital communication in all spheres. We have talked about it, I'm not repeating. Specializations ahead. I mean, the three area, broad areas are always in communication of information and analysis, communication of entertainment, and communication of persuasion and brand communication. So you have to take one of these and then go deeper into it to understand whether you are on the content side or on the business side or on the technology side. So you start from convergence, but you go niche and deeper inside. This mass com word has been coming a lot. Mass com is passe, that is 20th century. It's about media and communication today. Media platforms and communication functions. And the media platforms could be one-to-one communication for one-to-one communication, like Messenger, like WhatsApp, can be even a group communication. Again, there are groups in FB, Messenger, WhatsApp, everywhere. And there could be mass communication like radio, television, and newspaper. So communication is important. And there are different forms of communication, intrapersonal, interpersonal, group, and mass communication. So calling the entire thing as mass communication would be wrong in a web-first society, would be wrong in this post-pandemic world of communication. So that would be a point I'd like to note here. So media and communication, media are various platforms, online, offline, on air, on ground, and on mobile. And communication are various functions to inform, to educate, to engage, to entertain, to empower. You know, these are the various, to persuade, these are the various functions of communication. So let's look at a very exciting, exploring, expanding world of media and communication.
Let's just go across for our closing comments from our guest speakers as to what they thought about the show.
Of course, it's been a great learning for me as well. I always say, you know, that every such interaction helps us to also learn and grow. Very, very insightful. The audiences, of course, the students have been asking very interesting questions, which also shows their thinking and, you know, where they are headed to. In terms of closing remarks, I've already shared that. I think it's a great place to be in, great time to be in. So just go, enjoy, you know, flourish. Be unstoppable, because this is just the beginning for you guys. There is a whole world out there.
I think that is a great initiative, especially any initiative where there is collaboration and where there is participation, where there is exchange of ideas between the student community and industry experts. It should be definitely great.
This is a fine initiative. It is quite useful. And I think I've already told that earlier, the students need to worry too much. This too shall pass. And more importantly, these kind of platforms where there's lots of ideas being exchanged teaches one thing. It is so important to understand first and then be understood. So it is so important to listen to what others have to say, process them, and then try to articulate that, and then try to ask questions, and which is what is happening. So that's very important also in media.
It was very interesting to listen to three very interesting perspectives from journalism, Ms. Prema, from public relations and brand management, Ms. Sonia, and video, and also business management of media from Dilip. This was a fabulous program, and the choice of the panelists was very important to bring various facets and aspects of communication.
Such a pleasure to connect with all of you and get a holistic 360 degree view on media and communication.